Hello, my name is Cindy. I am from the Aquarium of the Pacific, but I'm also going to be your naturalist here on board today. And I'll be talking about any marine mammals that will hold you to see as we head off into the open ocean. Now, before we continue on, just by show of hands, has anybody ever done a whale watching trip before? I see a few hands, but I also have a lot of first comers as well. I'm hoping to make you a whale watching expert by the end of this trip. And there are certain signs that we look for when searching for marine mammals. One of those signs would be a lot of birds. If we're seeing a lot of birds all together that are at the surface of the water or diving into the water, that could be there's a lot of birds in that area. But that could attract our birds. It could attract our marine mammals as well. So again, we'll be looking for a lot of birds all together. A second sign that we look for is extra splashing. If we are seeing extra splashing, that could be if a group or a pod of dolphins, and they might be nearby. Of course, again, we'll be looking for that extra splashing. And the third sign that we look for are spouts. And depending on the type of whale, those spouts can look like a geyser of water or a puff of smoke. And those spouts can also be at further away or across, but we're going to be looking all over the ocean for those spouts. And we will be using the boat as a time clock. The front of the boat will be 12 o'clock. The right side of the boat will be 3 o'clock. The back side of the boat will be 6 o'clock. And the left side of the boat will be 9 o'clock. And we'll be using other numbers at the back. And just to give you an idea of about our 11 o'clock at 4 o'clock, you're going to see a few islands, and those are oil islands. They were designed by Disney to look like hotels that they all be crafting nicely, right? They even won awards for their conservation. And we can go into the harbor, out of the harbor.